Hi there, it's Naomi with Naomi Butler, the Naomi Butler Show. I am going to paint, and today is just a little past a week past chemo, and so I've been dealing with vertigo, so I'm a little bit dizzy, so you'll have a dizzy artist painting. Who knows, it may turn out really good, but I'm trying to push through and paint even though I'm a little dizzy. We're going to work on color song number one, and I'm going to try my best to finalize it. Who knows what's going to happen? It's like you can have a goal of something and then it not work, but we'll see. Anyway, I'm just going to try a couple of things. I want to put some more blues in here that I mixed up and just kind of go through here. I may add a little bit of that greenish blue in here. Have some more blue and dark colors throughout. I want to bring in some of that orangey color I mixed up, and it's kind of one of those darker colors of this. It's kind of like a burnt orange that I did. And we'll come back with some light colors. Just a minute. I'm not wanting this to be a long video, so I'm going to see what I can do in a short time. And who knows, it might go to another video, who knows, but we'll see. What I did last time, after the paint was on this glass palette, I pulled it off onto the Masterson palette, which is, I put a piece of foam under here, like a, whatever, just a piece of foam, and then I have the palette paper that you wet it all down, and then you close it with the lid, and it keeps it really moist. I gotta be careful turning fast. Anyway, I spray it with water, and the paints have been sitting here since that last time I painted, and they're still all soft and ready to go. They're not dried. This mixture right here, I wanna show this to you. This one right here was the leftover of all of those colors on this glass palette that I pulled into a pile, and it made mud. But if you notice, it made a really pretty light gray, which I'm gonna use for some of the background, because I mixed the white with that. But that's like part of all of the colors, so it really harmonizes that soft gray. I don't know how we're gonna end up, but we're gonna just kinda keep going here. So let's just play with some of these colors. And this is the kind of a gray with a few different colors that I made up, which I think it's kind of cool too. It's not as light, but it made it pretty gray. It's not just black and white. And it will, when you paint over some of these other colors, it kind of makes a lighter color. You see what I'm doing? That makes a lighter blue when you add it next to that blue. And I'm not even washing my brush because I'm just kind of using the same colors to blend with as I go and see what happens. So we'll play this by ear. All right, I'm gonna kind of start making some lighter marks with lighter blues, and we're gonna kind of see how this goes too. I just wanted to paint today so bad. I didn't care how dizzy I was, and thought, well, let's try it. And since it's not as bad as it was yesterday, we'll just again see what we can accomplish. Okay, I'm going to go in with some of this light gray, and I still have some blue on here, so it's going to create some lighter blue marks. See what it does inside that dark orange. Kind of cool. All right, I'm going to go back in with some of this really light gray to kind of start making a background. So it's kind of like painting the negative. Painting in layers like this is, instead of building a house, since this is not as big as a house, think of it as laying bricks. You got to put one layer on at a time, one on top of the other, and so that's kind of what I'm doing here. What I love is when you do this and you've got other colors and they kind of mix in as you go. Really, I like it. Anyway, it's kind of cool. You can see some of the other layers kind of coming through underneath all of this, which is kind of adding to the composition. So I'm going to kind of start up here also and see what we can accomplish up here too. really want some of this lighter yellow color in there with maybe a little bit of that color added to it. Add blue and yellow and you get a little green. So I'm wanting to kind of stay away from that green. I can. Pretty color. Got a little bit of the white in it. All right, so I kind of start back up here and think about how I'm going to finish at this composition. I think I've got a lot of the colors I want. I've got some of the dark blues, some of this dark burnt orange going on, and then I have some of the light of that same burnt orange. It really adds some color to it. Add some of this dark gray in different places. That was that harmonized color, and see what it looks like. Sometimes it's just like, what would that color look like there? How would that work? And that little bit of gray, I think I like that. Sometimes you just have to kind of get the paint off your brush and go back in with the color you want. Let me see what I got here.
adding some more of that light, I don't know, kind of a melon color. It's really pretty. Okay, I think I kind of accomplished what I want. And I want a little bit more of that burnt orange. Maybe it's just a little darker color of it that I want, but there's no rhyme or reason why you put a color where you want it. It's just a feel. So you can see so many colors underneath this gray, but so much depth. Yep, I have pain in my arm. It's okay. It's part of it. see what it looks like. I'm liking where it's going. I'm going to show it to you up close. See what y'all think. And then I'm going to try to put some of that light gray in it, inside it. Kind of pulls it together. Really am liking it. All right, so what do you think? Let's say it's done, and I'll sign my name down in here, and we're done with color song number 1. Thank you for sticking with me. See you later.